Please state your name for the court.
My name is Regan Thomas.
And where are you currently employed, Mr. Thomas?
I work for BNN.
And about how long have you been working at BNN?
Well, let's see. I started back in 2004, so it's about 5 years now I'm working around there.
And have you ever reported on any investigations before?
Yes, I have.
And what kind?
Well, usually working with BNN, I'm involved with murder investigations, celebrity gossip, political scandals, that sort of nature.
And did you have an occasion to do a report on September 24th, 2006?
Yes, BNN, Kip Berkshire, my present CEO, had me flown out to the Midland Civic Center to report on a gun debate.
And what was contained in your report?
Well, the nature of it was specifically I was there to cover the press conference afterwards with Drew Walton and Lane Hamilton, a professor at Midland University.
And now let's talk about your formulation of your broadcast. Now, did you speak with anybody that night?
Well, yes, I did. I spoke with Carla Kim.
And what did Harley Kim provide you with for your story?
Well, when speaking with him, he told me that Drew Walton and Lane Hamilton were arguing outside.
Objection, Your Honor. This has been called for hearsay.
Your Honor, we're not offering this for the truth of the matter, so I would rather be accepted as...
What's your response to that?
I believe the statement should be up for the truth of the matter asserted. And because he's telling him, he's discussing what he learned and how he included it in his report.
Overall.
Harley Kim, he spoke with me, and I learned that Drew Walton and Lane Hamilton were arguing outside the parking lot. And soon afterwards, Drew Walton pulled out a gun.
And did you speak with anybody else that night?
Yes, I spoke with Casey French.
And what did Ms. French provide you with for your story?
Ms. French, she saw the whole thing supposedly through the rearview mirror in a limo. It was very dark outside. Plus, I discounted her testimony because she works for me and I considered it biased.
And did you talk with anybody else?
Yes, I spoke with Mickey McQuiggan. He's the head death investigator.
And what did Mickey McQuiggan provide you with?
Well, he stated that when there's two people and one is dead, it sure doesn't look good for the other one. He immediately then looked up and recognized that I was a reporter, and then she started saying that the investigation is preliminary. I recognize this as political doublespeak. I've worked many years with different types of stories, and I can recognize those type of things.
And did you talk with anybody else?
Yes, I spoke with Janet Patel, the Civic Center janitor.
And what did Ms. Patel provide you with?
Ms. Patel, she ran up to me. She was very excited. She was speaking about America, proclaiming Drew Walton's innocence. It was very difficult to understand her, but she seemed very too excited. It was difficult to understand her, so I discounted her testimony.
And did you talk with anybody else that night?
I spoke with Captain Venuta, the police chief.
And what did Captain Venuta provide you with?
I learned that the gun that was used belonged to Drew Walton and was involved in Lane Hamilton's death.
And after speaking with all of these people, how did you decide which sources to use and not use in your broadcast?
Well, with my experience as a reporter, I learned to use sources that are credible, that are unbiased.
And after coming to your conclusions, what did you do?
I phoned Fran Martin to get permission to run the story.
And after you called Martin, what did you do next?
Well, Fran Martin didn't approve of my story, so I called Kip Berkshire.
And after talking to Kip, what had happened?
Well, he was very impressed with how I investigated this story, and he gave me permission to run it.
And do you stand by your report?
Yes, I do. And I believe it is 100%. Abide by the standards of journalism that Kip Berkshire provided for all BNN employees. In no way did I state that Drew Walton killed Lane Hamilton. I tried to make sure that I didn't sound too convinced. It was still an open and closed case. It wasn't officially shut. So interpretations were to be made.
Okay, thank you. No further questions.